There are three possible scenarios when reporting the SPSS results of the mixed ANOVA. Scenario 1. No observable effects. The results of the mixed ANOVA itself are reported. You start with the results corrected for the violation of sphericity, which I've explained in detail in the corresponding video. However, this correction is only required for the within subjects effect and the interaction effect. The test statistic is given together with the degrees of freedom and the p-value. Scenario 2. If an interaction effect between within subjects and between subjects effect could be observed, only this is reported. But beware, some reviewers may still insist on reporting main effects, although considering them in isolation is meaningless if an interaction was already observed. The effect size, usually the partial error squared, should also be reported and classified, primarily using comparable studies, research field specific thresholds, or Cohen 92. A generalized error squared can also be helpful. I've shown its calculation and interpretation in the linked video if you're interested. Scenario 3. If no interaction effect between the within subjects and between subjects effect could be observed, the main effects are then reported, regardless of their significance. In addition, the non-significance of the interaction effect is also reported. For scenarios 2 and 3, pairwise comparisons are also calculated using estimated marginal means. These also include the corresponding effect sizes. As these are always pairwise comparisons, this is Cohen's D, which is calculated slightly different depending on the effect being analyzed, which I've also shown in detail in the linked videos. Finally, the respective Cohen's D are categorized, which is primarily done with comparable studies or research field specific thresholds again. If neither is available, Cohen 92 and the provided thresholds can be used.